The pastime of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, known as Maha Prakash Lila, or the Great Proclamation, is fulfilling the desires of all the Vaishnavas. The Lord manifested. The Lord manifested the glorious Satprahariya Bhava, or the 21-hour long state and intense, deep spiritual emotions. By listening about the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya and his devotees, we attain the highest goals of life, bhakti, or love of God. In this pastime, the merciful Lord Gaura reveals his golden heart and explains that he appears in the lives of his devotees in different forms to exchange love with them and to freely give them pure love of God. Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually describes this pastime in his song Gaura Arati, by which he glorifies those devotees who fully surrender to the Lord. One day, Lord Gauranga came to the house of Srivas Pandit. Soon after that, his eternal associates, Advaita, Jagadish, Mukunda, and the rest joined him. They started to dance in love of God as usual. But then Gauranga suddenly stopped. Even though he commonly used to dance in the role of a devotee or a servant of the Lord, hiding his real identity of the divine person, on this special day, to the happiness of his devotees, Gaurahari went to the altar and sat on the Lord Vishnu's throne, putting the Shavagram Shila on his lap. In this way, he sat for 21 hours continuously, and his devotees surrendered him with their hearts filled with joy. Devotees felt immense pleasure as if they were on my punta, and everyone present there was freed from influence of the material energy. The devotees started serving Gaurachandra as a deity. They bathed him and offered him flowers, cooled him with chamaras, offered obeisances, chanted mantras, and presented him unbelievably opulent varieties of foodstuffs. Some devotees sang sweetly and the rest were crying, dancing, and rejoicing to finally be able to worship their Gauranga as the Supreme Personality of God, which was their long-cherished desire. The house of Srivas became an ocean of bliss, and even the demigods came to witness all this in secrecy. Each devotee was worshipping the Lord according to his heart's taste, following various rules. And maidservants in Srivas' house were also engaged by bringing Ganga water for the Abhishek, the bathing of the Lord. Maidservant named Duki was also bringing water when Lord Gaurasundar noticed her.
Who's that woman, Srivas? I always see her nicely and devotedly serving the Vaishnavas. She never tries to serve me directly, but instead, she's being happy to assist others in their services. That's Duki, the unfortunate one. She had a very tough life, and thus she got this name. Whoever serves me or my devotees cannot be called unfortunate. From now on, your name is Suki,
The fortunate one. Thank you, my sweet mom. Thus Lord Gauranga took away all her sorrow and misfortune. The devotees were overjoyed due to this special mercy that Sukhi received, exclaiming,
Joy! Joy!
Thanks to Srivas, who was a pure devotee, all the servants in his house were thus able to directly serve the lotus feet of Gaurachandra, which are the object of meditation even for the Lord Brahma, Shiva, and Goddess Lakshmi. The blessings received by these simple devotees are unknown even to those scholars who spend all their lives studying the Vedas. And then the Lord started revealing the glories of his devotees and their dedicated lives. The Lord first addressed Srivas Pandit, who is known as a devotee who gave everything for the service of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. His body, mind, family, house, riches, servants and friends, there is no end to Srivas' dedication and love.
Oh, Srivas, do you remember the times when there were no devotees in Navadvip? How you used to come to the house of Devananda Pandit to listen to the discourses on Srimad Bhagavatam? Each verse of Bhagavatam is saturated with Krishna Prem, and your heart was melting listening to it. On one occasion, you cried out loudly due to a sudden feeling of intense love and you fell to the ground, unconscious. The ignorant people there did not understand your behavior and they threw you out on the street without you even noticing it. Devananda Pandit, their teacher, the impersonalist, did not protest. When you regained your consciousness, you realize that you are alone on the street and you return to your house with sadness in your heart. Do you remember that, Srivas?
Yes, my Lord, I remember that. Since that time, I was longing for that love I felt in Devananda Pandit's house. Nothing else mattered to me.
All day long you used to retreat at Bhagavatam and cry for Krishna. You retreated yourself from any association. But your sorrow is my sorrow as well. Therefore, when I saw you so distressed, I came all the way from Vaikuntha and took place in your heart. I gave you that ecstatic love for me. And in that way, you became happy again.
Hearing this, Srivas Pandit fell before the Lord's feet in ecstasy, as the rest of the devotees were jubilantly dancing and chanting,
Jai! 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 Kanana! All glories to the Son of Mother Sachi!
Hear me all! Even a dog in the house of Srivas Pandit is dear to me. Know that even if all the worlds go poor and Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, has to go begging from door to door, I swear that nothing will ever be lacking in the house of Srinath Pandit, because I am personally maintaining him along with his housemaids, servants and animals.
Thank you.
Do you remember Gangadas?
That night, when the soldiers of the Muslim ruler came to conquer your village?
I remember, my lord. In great fear, with my family, I ran away from my house, and we ran to the bank of Ganga, hoping to find some boats to cross it. But alas, there were no boats, none. So soldiers were coming closer and closer, and the sun was rising. I was really scared. I was so afraid, crying and thinking that they will be torturing and killing my family. So, my lord, I thought really, it was better that all of us simply drown in the Ganga. I was so sad. And then, one boatman appeared. He was very unusual and beautiful. And he took us over the river and thus saved our lives.
That was me, Gangadas. I came there to help you. I remember you then telling me with great affection, my dear brother, please, take us now to a safe place. I am surrendering to you my whole body, wealth, and life. I depend on you alone. Then I took you over and returned to Vaikuntha.
My lord, thank you, thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh.
Lord Gaurasundar was in such a magnanimous mood, ready to give best benedictions to his devotees and their relatives. He ordered to the devotees,
"Bring me Sridhar, now!"
"Who is that Sridhar? How shall we recognize him?"
"Go to the very end of Navadvip and you will find him constantly calling out for me."
A simple and honest Kolavechara Sridhar sustained himself by selling coal or banana tree leaves. And whatever little profit he would make, half of it he would spend on worshipping the holy Ganga River. To everyone, he seemed like an ordinary small seller, and his heart remained unknown to the majority. He would spend his nights happily immersed in chanting Krishna's name, forgetting about sleeping. Neighbors would complain, saying that they cannot sleep because he's chanting the whole night simply due to being hungry.
Sridhar! Sridhar!
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna.
Oh, saintly Sridhar, Lord Gaura has sent us to bring you before his lotus feet.
Me? Lord Gaura calls for me? Oh!
He's always with me within his mind. We know each other since always. When I was a young scholar, I used to come to you. You were so poor that your hut was terribly ruined. It had many holes on the roof. But you were the only one on the market who had the best and cheapest bananas. Still, half of your meager profit you used to use for worship of Ganga. Do you remember that, Sridhar? Do you remember? I was coming every day for your bananas.
Yes,
How wouldn't I remember that person? Enchanting like the most beautiful diamond. So beautiful, it would captivate even the mind of Cupid. But quite demanding. For your bananas, I offered only half price. But I considered my price to be quite fair. I would bargain for hours and hours over the price, and then, in the end, I would simply snatch your bananas arrogantly. I would then stand up and try to get them back. And I would say, you are hiding the whole treasure. And to me, you wouldn't love the price. What? What treasure? My dear Brahmana, please. Isn't there any other seller around? If I am too expensive, why don't you buy from someone else? Oh no! Oh no! I really want to buy from you! I couldn't even think of leaving such a trustworthy supplier. If you are spending half of your profits on Ganga worship, why couldn't you give half discount to me? To me? Who's the source of Ganga? And I would then shout and close my ears, Vishnu, Vishnu, I don't want to hear any more of this. Take these bananas for half a price and go away, you beautiful, restless boy who steals my heart by some mysterious way. Sridhar. I was very pleased with our exchanges and your pure devotion. I really like to accept and relish things from my devotees, but at the same time, I don't need anything from non-devotees. Tell me, what do you desire from me? I can give you anything you ask for. I can give you a kingdom and priceless treasures. No, no, my lord. I can give you 8 mystic perfections. My lord, I do not desire anything from you. I am not a merchant to ask for something in exchange for my love. Please. Don't let me ask for anything. You already gave me everything I need. Please, Sridhar, I really want to give you something. Take at least for my sake. All right, my lord. I only wish that life after life I see this beautiful Brahmana boy with whom I used to argue over my bananas. May only he be my eternally worshipped master, whose name I sing with great love. My dear devotee, I give you the blessing of pure love for me, which is the greatest secret of all the Vedas.
Jai! Jai!
Then Chaitanya turned toward Murari Gupta, who is always compassionate to all living beings and who is an ocean of good qualities and pure devotion. Murari, or Krishna, is Gupta, hidden in his heart. That's the meaning of his name.
Murari, look at me. Tell me, what do you see?
I see you! I see you as the Lord Ramachandra, sitting on a royal throne with a bow in his hand. With you are Lakshman and Sita. And there are numerous monkeys showing their reverence. Well, indeed, I'm your servant, Hanuman.
Hey, Hanuman, I remember how the King Ravana set your tail fire and you then angrily burned out his whole city. Hey, Hanuman, I am your master and you are my faithful servant. Stand up, Hanuman! Stand up, Murari! Ask for anything you want. I will give you any benediction.
I have only one wish, my lord. Wherever I may be born, again and again, I only wish to be able to serve you and sing your glories. Oh my lord, don't let me ever forget that I'm your eternal servant and you are my most worthy master. Whenever you appear with your associates, I wish to be with you. I desire to serve you as your insignificant servant.
Fulfilled, fulfilled. You have this blessing, Murari.
Joy!
Joy! Joy!
After this, Gaurahari started to wave his head and repeat the name.
Nada! 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 Acharya, ask for anything you want.
My prayers are already fulfilled, my lord.
Advaita, you are the one who invoked me from my abode. And you are the one who is the most compassionate towards all living beings rotting in the material world. And you are the one who is the best among devotees. You are enjoying when I am being glorified and you can't tolerate when I am glorifying you, considering yourself to be only the servant of my servant.
I cannot say anything except that it is my great fortune and glory to have you as my lord and master. Please, give your mercy to this ignorant and fallen soul.
Then Chaitanya raised his hands high and requested the devotees to ask for any blessings. Some devotees said, "My father is protesting because I am a devotee. Please let him change and become a devotee himself." Others were asking blessings for their disciples, children, wives, servants, and so on. Some were asking, "Please let my faith in my guru increase." Then Gaurasundara gave the remnants of his prasada to the little girl Narayana, the niece of Srivastava. She ate it with great joy. The devotees congratulated her for her good fortune.
Joy!
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 Cry for Krishna in great ecstasy!
Krishna! Krishna!
Krishna.
Mother Sachi? What about her? Why can't you give her Krishna Prema just like you are giving it to all of us?
My dear devotees, unfortunately, this is not possible.
Why? What happened?
Mother Sachi offended the respectable Advaita Acharya. Before my brother Vishwarup took sannyas, he used to visit Advaita Acharya. And then, when I started to visit him again as well, she thought in her mind that I will also, due to his association, take sannyas. Thus, she thought that the more appropriate name for him would be Dvaita, the hypocrite, and not Advaita. Only if she gets his forgiveness will it be possible for my mother to receive the gift of prema, pure love of God. Let her take the dust from his holy feet and thus show that she repents for that offense.
I'm so sorry. I do repent. I will do whatever is required. Mother Sachi offending me? That's impossible. I do not take any offense from her. And what to say of her taking the dust from my feet? Unheard of. I cannot let that happen. Mother Sachi is the mother of most exalted Lord Gora. She is the mother of all universe. And she is none other than Mother Yashoda, Krishna's own mother, who deserves all our reverence. From the dust of her lotus feet, we are seeking life after life. Yashoda Ma! Oh, Sachi Ma! Yashoda Ma! Oh, Sachi Ma!
Advaita Acharya started to fall in trance, glorifying the Mother Sachi, thus completely losing external consciousness. Mother Sachi took this opportunity to quickly take the dust from his feet, but then she fainted from the contact with the powerful bhakti that emanates from every pore of Advaita Acharya's system. All the devotees were beside themselves, extremely joyful to witness such loving exchanges between devotees. Lord Gaura was happy and pleased seeing this act from his own mother and gave her all his special blessings. In this way, he warned all the Vaishnavas about the danger of offending his devotees who are dearer to him than his own life. Chaitanya didn't want to call him, and no one could understand why was the Lord ignoring their close and dear friend who possessed simple and spontaneous devotion for Gauranga.
My dear Lord, what happened with Mukunda? I know he's dear to you, and we all love him very much. Who is the one whose heart is not melting when Mukunda sings? But you seem to be ignoring him, not inviting him amongst us. If he committed any offense, why can't you simply punish him
Please, Lord, call him to you.
Don't ask me about that deceiver, whoever pretends to be humble and then acts violently is a real cheater. Well, there is Mukunda. He comes to me humble, as a blade of grass, but the very next moment hits me with an iron rod. I don't want to see him ever again.
Who could understand your inconceivable powers by which you have mystic insights? We never noticed anything offensive in Mukunda's behavior.
That rascal agrees with any philosophy just to fit in the association he is in the association of Vaishnavas. He humbly sings and dances, and when he is in another place, he refutes the superiority of bhakti. If someone criticizes bhakti and claims that there is a more powerful process than bhakti, it is like hitting me with an iron rod. This is a serious offense, and therefore I cannot accept him. I cannot see his face again.
Yes, the Lord knows. Long time ago, on the order of my guru, I refused to follow the process of devotional service. What should I do now? My life has no meaning any longer. I do not wish to live anymore. Shivas, Shivas. Oh, hear me, Shivas! Please, please tell me, will I be able to see my Lord Gauranga ever again?
Mukunda's stay touched the compassionate hearts of the devotees. They approached the Lord and prayed for Mukunda.
Please, Lord, have mercy on Mukunda. He is begging you to know, when will he see you again?
He will be able to see me only after 10 million lifetimes.
I will see him! 10 million! Only 10 million! I will see my Lord Gauranga! I will see! Only 10 million!
Shrivas, bring him here now!
I'll see him.
Stand up, my dear Mukunda. Your faith in the truthfulness of my words has removed all your previous doubts and offenses. Now I am forever conquered by your love and devotion. You are my singer, and wherever you sing, I shall be present at that place. I always reside on your tongue in the form of the holy name.
Devotees were rejoicing Mukunda's great fortune more than they would rejoice receiving those blessings themselves. They exclaimed,
Joe!
Maha Prakash Lila. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hare Krishna.